नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्या पटोमस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ यूकेरियोटिक सेल्स। द टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम द फंडामेंटल ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बीटी थर्ड ट्राइमेस्टर बीएससीएफ एंड थर्ड ट्राइमेस्टर। सो फर्स्ट let me introduce what are the eukaryotic cells. U means tube and karyon means nucleus. The cells which have two nucleus are known as the eukaryotes. So the nucleus of the eukaryotes is surrounded by a nuclear membrane. The eukaryotic cells are of two types. The first one is plant cells and the second one is animal cells. Without these other types of cells may also exist, but they have similarity. The difference is only in the plant cells and the animal cells. Other types of organisms include fungi, yeast, algae. These are also included in the eukaryotes, but the difference is main differences between the plant cell and the animal cells. So we discuss about these two cells. So this is the structure of the plant cell and it is the structure of the animal cells. So now we discuss about the structural organelles of eukaryotes. These are the organelles which are in the eukaryotes. So first nuclear organelle is plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is the outermost layer in the humans, in the animals, but in plant cells or in some microbes, cell wall is the outer membrane. The plasma membrane separates the external environment to the cell and it protects the cell cytoplasm. So the structure of the plasma membrane has the model given by the fluid mosaic model, in which the plasma membrane has the phospholipid and the protein molecules are embedded in the it. The plasma membrane is selectively permeable to some molecules which are necessary, and it discards some molecules which are not necessary for the cell. So it helps in the movement, it helps in the selective permeability of the cell. The next one is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the jelly like substance between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Nucleus is present in the cytoplasm. It is present in the cytoplasm. All the organelles are present in the cytoplasm, such as mitochondria, ribosomes, RNA, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex. These are present in the cytoplasm. Next organelle is in nucleus. Nucleus is the main organelle which differentiates between the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. The nucleus is present in the central cell and it plays the central role in the cellular functioning, because all the proteins are secreted by DNA material, using the replication, transcription, translation process, and they are secreted into the cytoplasm. But the process starts in the nucleus, and it contains the DNA, it contains the genetic information. So the nucleus is the most important part of the eukaryotes. And the nucleus is surrounded by a nuclear membrane, which is the clear, very clear in eukaryotes. Next is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is the network of membranous filled fluids. Endoplasmic reticulum carries some materials throughout the cell, and they have important role in the transport. Similarly, they have the specific organelle that role in the defense system, because the major histocompatibility complex or human leukocyte antigens are present in the endoplasmic reticulum, and it identifies the unknown compounds and provide defense to the cell and to the organism. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. The first one is rough endoplasmic reticulum, which has ribosomes on its surface. The second one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum, which has not any ribosomes on its surface. It means if ribosomes are present, it is known as the rough endoplasmic reticulum. If ribosomes are absent, it is known as the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The next organelle is mitochondria. Mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of the cell. It is surrounded by a double membrane. And what is the role of the mitochondria? Mitochondria has the important role in the respiration of the cell. It is important role in the cycling, various types of glycogen cycling, and it has a central role in the oxidation. It has central role in the respiration of the cell. It then generates ATP by the process of respiration, so it is known as the powerhouse of the cell. Next organelle is chloroplast, which is present only in the plants. It is absent in the animals' cell. It uses sunlight and produce the nutrients for the plants. The process by which it utilizes the sunlight is known as the photosynthesis, and it synthesizes the nutrient materials for the plants. Next organelle is lysosome. Lysosome is the small degrading digestive containing enzyme containing organelle. Because lysosome have some specific molecules that are known as the lysozymes. They have the lytic activity. Okay. They have lytic activities. Sometimes they may also engulf its own cells. Sometimes they may also damage its own cells. So it can be also known as the suicidal bags. Lysosomes are also known as the suicidal bags due to this property. They are also known as the garbage collector of the cells, because they decompose the unnecessary cells, the unnecessary parts, the unnecessary parts which are present, and the cells which have been died, they kill these cells. Next is ribosomes. Ribosomes are the major organelles which have important role in the protein synthesis. Okay, they synthesize proteins in the cytoplasm, and they are present in the cytoplasm, and they are 70S types and 80S types. 70S types are found in the prokaryotes, 80S types are found in the eukaryotes. But in the eukaryotes, there are 80S types. The two subunits include 60S subunit and the 40S subunits according to their sedimentation size. The next organelle is cell wall, which is found only in the plant cells or maybe in the some microbes. But it cell wall is present in the plant and microbes, but it is absent in the animal cells. It is made up of cellulose, and it maintains the cell shape, provide protection from the external damage to the cell. Vacuole are the fluid filled organelles enclosed by a membrane. they have storage capability. They store the food which has been synthesized, so that the plants can use the stored food material from the vacuoles. They are present in the animals, but it is smaller in the size, but the vacuoles which are present in the plant cells are larger in size. Next is cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton is made up of the microtubules, actin and intermediate filaments, and it provides the cell shape and help the cell organize the cell parts and help the cells to move. So whatever the cell shape is due to the cytoskeleton. The next organelle is cilia and flagella. The cilia and flagella, as the name indicates, these were also found in the prokaryotes, but they are also in the eukaryotes. If we are confused on the term cilia and flagella, and we are confused, the flagella is also found in the animals, and they are characteristic of. Their characteristic includes they are hair-like structure, and their size is about 1 to 10 micrometer in length, and they have important role in dirt of some lungs linings. The flagella have important role in the cell movement. So now we discuss about the difference between plant cells and animal cells. The plant cell has a cell wall, but animal cells do not have any cell wall. The plant cell have chloroplast for photosynthesis, but animal cells do not have. The plant cell have big central vacuole, the animal cell have smaller ones. The plant cell has centrioles, but the plant cell do not have centrioles, and animal cell have centrioles. This is the part of the nucleus. Chromosomes, this is the part of the chromosomes. Which is absent in the plant and present in the animal cells. Now lysosomes, which are absent in the plants and present in the animal cells, which have important role in the defense mechanism. The plant cells are larger inside, but animal cells are smaller in size. The plant cell reserve their food in the form of starch, and animal cell reserve their food in the form of glycogen. And the nucleus is present in the one side of the cytoplasm, and in animal cells the nucleus is present in between the center, lies in the center of the cytoplasm. And the plant cell is rectangular in the shape, but animal cell is round in shape. The plant cell have not a true Golgi complexes, but they have dicotysomes. But the animal cells have a true Golgi complexes. They do not require any dicotysomes. So these are the difference. And next we discuss about the different types of cell organelles in the prokaryotes. So this is the lecture is over here.